described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
New Dimension Media QUESTAR presents Greatest Human Achievements, Sending Messages. A bird flies across the sky. A paper is slipped under a band around a bird's leg. Many pigeons fly from shelves.
Once, pigeons were the fastest way to send a message.
They fly away in slow motion. In archival footage, someone slips a letter in a mailbox.
Fortunately for birds, mail services soon took over, aided by the new railways. But it still took time.
Letters in open boxes move on a conveyor belt.
If the recipient was overseas, a very long time.
Sacks fall from the end of a chute.
Even urgent messages could take days, if not weeks, to arrive.
Baskets are labeled with various locations, and sacks are wheeled away.
But in 1838, Samuel Morse, investigating the newly discovered powers of electricity, had a brainwave.
A small lever is tapped.
He devised a code of long and short electrical impulses that could be transmitted through a cable. At the other end, a machine responded to the impulses, printing them onto a roll of paper. Messages could be sent and received almost instantly.
Cables go in and out of boxes.
Telegraph cables were laid at record speed, even across the English Channel.
Sun shines on an ocean.
The Atlantic was a much tougher challenge. It wasn't until 1865, after several failed attempts, that a fully functioning cable was finally laid, and instant communication between Europe and America was at last established.
Waves roll onto a beach. Small wheels turn and gears turn sporadically. Long, narrow paper has holes punched into it.
It's hard now to imagine the impact of the telegraph on a world that had never experienced anything faster than letter post.
A wheel of ink goes up and down, printing dashes and dots on moving paper.
But the telephone, the telegraph's natural heir, was to take communication even further.
Wires wrapped around a post run along a floor.
Like the telegraph, it transmits electrical signals through cables. But these signals can be faithfully decoded at the other end, not as dots and dashes, but as sound.
In archival footage, a man turns a crank on a telephone, and operators with headsets sit at desks with buttons on them. Earlier operators sit at walls of holes where cables are connected.
Now it was possible to hold a conversation with someone many hundreds or even thousands of miles away.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.